Welcome, welcome to another episode on Illustrate Radio. I got my beautiful, beautiful, beautiful co-host. How you doing, Tigray?
I'm good. Woo, how are you?
I'm doing good under the circumstances, but I'll be okay. Wagwan, did ya?
Wagwan, what's going on with you?
Not a whole lot.
It's a good day.
You know what I'm saying? But it's a good day. We're gonna make it. We're gonna keep it. We're gonna keep it at a good day. You know what I'm saying? So before we get into it and start the show, I want to make sure that we do a special shout out to our Studio 202 DC page, where we are live every Wednesday at 9 o'clock. And yeah, shout out to Bliss FM. I'm sorry, I'm having a moment here, so y'all bear with me. Y'all make sure y'all check us out on 7 On Demand. We are there every Wednesday at 8 o'clock. So if you miss us this week, you can definitely catch us on there next week. And if you just want to catch up on all of our episodes, please be sure to visit www.7od.net. Yes, and we are on a loop, so just go ahead and put the Illustrate. We're on your Roku. We're on your 7 On Demand. We're on your YouTube. We're on your Twitch. We're on everywhere. Apple Podcasts, Anchor, you name it, we're there. So just make sure y'all like, follow, subscribe, and please share this live if you are on it right now. Don't be scared to do that. So again, we're going to start the show off with my luck. Okay, so it is just my luck that I keep running into these conversations about COVID, vaccination, political conversations that I really don't want to have. I am tired of having these. So I want to come from a point, and I want to show everyone that we need to come from a level of understanding. And if we are not listening to understand, then I am no longer listening. If we are not listening to learn, I am no longer listening. Honestly, I no longer want to have these conversations at all, because I just feel as though you should do what's best for you. You cannot hold anyone else accountable. You cannot say that this is a level of responsibility that anyone should have to you or the public, because I have to do what's right for me and my children, and I want everyone to do what's right for them. Do your own research. And at this point, I'm only having conversations that are conducive to your health. So if you tell me that you took the stick, you know what I'm saying? You got the little joint or whatever, that's fine. Go ahead and make sure you stock up on your collagen, your chlorophyll, your spirulinas, your spices and stuff like that, your fruits and your vegetables. Make sure you stay in tune and you eat healthy, because, you know, we're quick to put a lot of foreign stuff in our bodies anyway. Who am I to judge? Because I like foreign shit in my body. You like foreign shit in your body. If you're having sex, it's foreign. If you are having sex, it's foreign. Okay? A lot of us are eating processed food. We're doing a lot of different things. So with that being said, do what is best for you. We all got our vices. I smoke, I drink, we do all of those different things. Do what's best for you at the end of the day. I am no one to judge. I don't care to be right. I don't care to prove you wrong. So protect your peace by any means necessary and do what's best for you and everyone else. Mind your business and stop talking to me about COVID and all the different multiple strains that are coming out now. I don't care. Okay? Thank you. Go ahead, so Tigray.
Thank you.
I just know I had a little rant. Right. What you got for us?
I feel like I ain't got nothing for the people.
That was pretty so good. Thank you.
Guys, oh, happy Wednesday. I hope you all are enjoying thus far. We got a dynamic show for you all tonight, you guys. I'm super excited because we have a guest in the second half. And so my guest in the second half kind of brings me around to my love. And my love in today is love. And don't never hold your tongue. I'm going to tell you why. A lot of times people will talk themselves in or out of good situations, and not necessarily talking in a literal way, but in your mind, we get in our head about stuff. And sometimes we could see opportunities and not take them, not jump on them. So I want you all to be vigilant in ignoring that little thing that sits on your shoulder, the little thing in your head that tells you you can't, you shouldn't, you whatever, because you never know what may come out of it. So over the weekend, Illustrate was supposed to be doing some really big shit, and we ended up not doing it. And I was low-key deflated, you guys. When I didn't go in front, I was in my feelings. And when I seen the pictures of the video shoot after, I was like, ugh. Anyway, I was mad. But on the back end, I was out with my kids. I was enjoying myself and just happened to see a guy doing a photo shoot. And you ever know how somebody look like they somebody they look like they about to be? And something just said, you know, go say something to this guy. Total stranger, never seen him before. It's a shit ton of people out. He's doing this shoot, minding his business. And something said, yo, just say something to the man. And so I kindly edged him and said, hey, are you an artist? Coincidentally, he was an artist, DMV artist, trying to make it to a name for himself. He's also a manager, also a producer, but doing his own thing. I said, yo, come and do this show. And he was with it. So he's our guest tonight. Yo, I swear, I really low-key pulled up on this total stranger and was like, yo, you look like you somebody because you look like you got this whole 50 Cent situation happening. But anyway, I say all that to say this. Something could be so apparent to you and you could talk yourself out of it. You could close your own doors before they even have an opportunity to open. Now, granted, the artist that's coming on, he's new to the industry, new to the game, but he's doing his own thing. He's building his own sound, building his own voice, producing his own stuff, writing his own songs. We don't know how big this artist is going to be one day. And what if Illustrate is the catalyst for that? What if by happenstance, me meeting him is going to end up being something so big for all of us? We don't know. But I would never find out if I kept my mouth shut. I would never find out if I didn't listen to that little thing inside of me that's telling me, hey, you should, you should, you should. And so many times people, when we're out here, we don't listen to that. We ignore that. We talk ourselves out of that. We talk ourselves out of blessings. We block our own blessings so, so often. And I would only say, and just maybe challenge people to start tuning in, start dialing into yourself, start listening, because you never know what good is going to come from. And you don't know what positive thing is going to happen. You don't know what thing is going to happen as far as networking, as far as growing your brand, growing you as a person. You absolutely never know. Absolutely never know. I just want to challenge people to just don't keep your mouth shut. Start speaking up. Start speaking up. When you see an opportunity, you get out there, you seize it, you take it, because you never know what may happen. In this case, we got a dynamic guest. We might even be able to get him to sing a little something for us. We don't know. But if it goes, it's going to be phenomenal. And I already spoken into existence.
See, nice. That's what I'm talking about. You know, we all about the good vibes. I think we had a really good just my luck and love, and that was really dope. Thank you. I think we all needed to hear that on many different levels. It's crazy how fluidity happens and how things can kind of just work cohesively for you. And it's almost always there. And I said it to you. I said, when one door closes, something else opens. Maybe this wasn't the opportunity for us, but it was meant for you to meet him. So I can't wait to actually bring him on too in the second half as well. And it brings me with great sadness to even reiterate this news. But we're going to get into it with our Spit That-ish segment. Chucky Thompson, a DC native, somebody who was pivotal to R&B, especially during the 90s, and even with some current, with working with Mary J. Blige and in her new, what was her show called? I'm sorry, I'm getting a little choked up. Take Me As I Am, her new docuseries.
Yeah,
he was also a part of that project. Anyway, he was just an overall awesome person, a Grammy-nominated producer. And again, he's worked with multiple artists from Total, Nas, Biggie, Mary. And this is just a slight few. I didn't know him them directly on a personal level, but I knew many people that did. And what I've gathered the most was that he was a very loving person, and he always shared that love with anyone and everyone that he came across. If you were an up-and-coming artist and you didn't know Chucky, then you wasn't doing something right, because he was definitely tapped in and tuned in to what was also going on in DC. He brought a lot of events to the city as well, some of which I attended. He's probably one of the main reasons too why P. Diddy used to throw his parties that he did in DC during Howard Homecoming. But just an overall awesome person. And I know his best friend and my best friend are also just mourning. So again, I would just like to have a slight moment of silence and respect for him. And I can't wait for us to play a couple of his songs that I definitely didn't even know that he touched. So anyway, just a moment of silence. Respectfully, rest in peace, Chucky. It was very unfortunate. What an amazing person. Oh, I'm sorry. My heart was heavy on that one. My heart was beating really fast because, like, just, you know, knowing all the things that he's done and all the projects that he's worked on, he's just been awesome. Okay, so talking about music and just recirculating energy, because I'm always saying that energy never dies, it transcends. So again, Beyoncé is doing something that is amazing. She is building a hemp honey farm. And I'll say, okay, well, she revealed last year during quarantine, she learned how to overindulge into creating positive rituals drawing from past generations. During that time, she said she discovered CBD. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm going to get it together because...
All right. Okay. So she said, you guys, she discovered CBD on her last tour, and she has experienced the benefits and the soreness of inflammation. She's experienced the benefits, but she used it for her inflammation and her soreness. So she says that she also found healing properties in honey that benefit her and her children. And so now, because of this just enormous positive experience that she's had, she is now building a hemp and honey farm. So she is definitely excited. She's excited to be doing this and sharing this with her daughters, just to be an example to them and of things that they should do as far as self-care. So she is excited to be sharing these things with her daughters. She also added that one of her most satisfying moments as a mom is just her in Blue soaking in the bath and just, you know, doing their thing, using their bath blends. And that, I'm going to be quite honest with you guys, as a mom, that is, you know, one of those things that I miss, because my kids are pretty much grown, except for my 8-year-old, but we both too big to be in the bathtub together. But I miss that. I miss that phase. So again, just as far as self-care and just making sure that we're okay. People a lot of times disregard the use of CBD, but to be honest, it is a healing power in it. A lot of people do kind of disregard the things that can happen as far as positive for us using honey. But if you are somebody with allergies, you need to be getting that honey every day, to be honest with you. It'll help get you right, especially if you lose. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, and if you have allergies to honey, you can also do alternatives. I also do have CBD drops. There are plenty of companies that also sell them. A great company is in Canada. You know, CBD is close to my heart. So now that I got my bearings together, I can.
close to my heart.
You can literally get the drops, and you can do it in agave as well. Hemp honey, that's a very great segue. I think that as far as just getting into the industry and introducing it to so many others, CBD has endless benefits. Y'all make sure y'all check out Cincy Sweet for them good old CBD treats, bars. And that's Cincisuite. Y'all like how I did that drop? But yeah, CBD is great. Shout out to Beyonce for what she's doing. I think this is dope.
I'm sorry, you guys. I am multitasking because I'm also communicating with our guests. I do apologize. All right, so
talking about self-care, I'm going to say talking about self-care and all these different types of inflammation, there's been a lot of a spark going on the internet referencing to celebrities not bathing or washing themselves. This is absolutely disgusting. Okay.
They're nasty. I'm sorry. Really? I was going to let you. I'm so tired of white folks not washing their ass. Now I'm sorry.
And then wondering. And then wondering why germs and all these different types of. There's diseases and things that develop when you do not wash. Ashton Kutcher actually quoted and said he washes his crotch and his armpits daily and nothing else. You're nasty, bro. You're nasty. That's disgusting. That's not even, is that a male version of a bird bath? Like, I'm
My issue is with it. First, people want to have a whole discussion about using washcloth versus not using washcloths. I feel like it's your personal choice. Okay. Yes, sure. You should get yourself a new washcloth. Yes, you should use a different one for your face than you use for your ass.
Your body. Yeah.
But if I got enough money to buy me as many washcloths as I want, leave me alone. I might not want to wash up with my hand. I might not just want to stand there and hope for the best. And I'm going to tell y'all how y'all dirty asses know. Your ass, get yourself a white washcloth and a white towel. If you wash your ass and that thing is black, brown, whatever other color, guess what? You need to get your ass back in there. I'm tired of people walking around here with this one hand and thinking this one hand is going to get every nook, cranny, crack, crevice.
It's not. Y'all teaching y'all children to do one bath a week.
And then you wonder why these little kids got lice. That's why, because they ain't washing their hair.
And wonder why shit is spreading. Because y'all nasty.
How is it that you don't want to wash your ass? But when Donald Trump told y'all to drink bleach, you drink that. Help me help you. I don't understand.
I'm gonna need for y'all to drink bleach again. Fuck, and go clean out them insides because y'all dumb as shit not taking no damn. Anyway, we gonna look.
The nerve. Clearly that touched the nerve with your girl.
The fact that this is even a fad on the internet is a problem. That celebrities are really talking about them not washing their asses. With all this other shit but we got going on, y'all really... And y'all trying to make it worse. It's like y'all trying to say, you know what? Let me add some fuel to the little corona pandemic or plandemic. Let me add some more fuel to that so that now we can say, oh, this is the reason why, you know, germs are spreading is because no one's washing that ass. Well, I hope that y'all are being safe because...
Mimi, I'm going to need your mix to motivate them to wash their butt. I'm gonna need your mix to do to motivate them to watch. I need something that's gonna make them get in between their toes. I'm gonna need something that's gonna make them get this spot behind their ear. I'm gonna need something that's gonna make them clean out their belly buttons. All these spaces you girls that y'all don't touch all week, that's nasty as shit. I need your mix to do that. I need your mix to do that.
Wash your ass, girl.
Give me that. Let's get this mix going. Our guest is in the building. He's going to be coming up next. The DMV artist, Black Smith. We got a little something in the mix, too, so you guys can check out his music. Mimi's going to kick it. We're going to make all these white folks wash their butt, and we be right
back. That's a lot of pressure, Mimi. It's no pressure. You can do your thing. Ain't no pressure, baby. Go ahead and do your mix, baby. Ain't no pressure. Got you.
This has gone too far.
Sorry to the game. And me to take our pipe and our wife. You see?
Oh, you know what? Good.
Since we're on washing the ass,
I think this is only right, and then we're gonna get into the guest song. Our guest, Mr. Black Smith, coming up. New single. Let's get it.
Juice. This is a new single by our guest, Black Smith. I'm going to play this one time. This was Rooftop Vibes. This is the mix. We got him coming on in a second. He's talking about his music and his career. Okay, got a little Afro beat. Okay, Mr. Snap.
You got to do it here for.
Again, this is our guest coming up right after this. It's the Black Smith. Nothing can compensate. I'm riding to the top. Where you at? Let's go ahead and bring our guests on. Let's go ahead and get it started up. Oh, we got a little melody of songs. He mixed it up.
Yeah. I like that. I like that. Yo, welcome back to Illustrate Radio. You guys already know I am T. Gray. That is my beautiful co-host, Lucky DJ Stiletto at the bottom. And we have our dynamic guest in the building, DMV artist Black Smith. Come on in.
Yay.
Yo, yo,
yo. Hey, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being a part of Illustrate Radio tonight. So, for those of
you
who have not met this young man, yo, you're welcome. Up and coming DMV artist, doing his own thing, making his own way, which we always love here at Illustrate. We definitely love to support Black business and Black people just getting theirs and doing their thing. Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got into the industry.
Well, I got into the industry, I began about 2012 professionally. Beforehand, I just been fooling around with songwriting and things of that nature. But then began taking it a little more serious around 2012, opened a boutique label and was managing some artists and songwriting and producing for those artists. And then, you know, the relationships didn't last, but so I continued on in music because it's a love for me. And I began to sing for myself. I would always sing hooks and write the melodies for those artists myself anyway. So I began to take a little more serious on my own end.
That's awesome. So that's what's up. It seems like you did a lot of work and you work with some awesome people. I would really like to know some of the songs that you may have written or some of the artists that you've worked with.
Okay, I had an artist named Milan. We're all up and coming. I had another artist named Kid Rilla, and I work with Ethan Spaulding. I work with a few other artists, but nothing.
Oh, named. So that's dope because I actually know Ethan. That's super dope. I know Ethan as well. I'm sorry, it's a little bit of a delay, so I'm going to try not to overtalk you.
Oh, no, it's okay. So one thing that I like about the singer-songwriter is just really how much dedication you all put into your projects. Can you tell us about your most recent project and maybe what's your favorite song on there?
My most recent project is Rooftop Vibes, and my favorite song would have to be Lifestyle. That's the most recent that I've been promoting. I love the song because it speaks to love of the music, love of the sound, living free, and just adapting to the environment. And a lot, what we have to do is we have to be outside now. So I try to create melody and music that just gives us that freedom on the outside to just explore and just to be in the moment.
Okay, so do you have anything else or any, I mean, where do you see yourself going, or like as far as your next project, what's your next thing that you kind of want to work on?
Well, recently I've decided that I'm going to just do singles.
Okay.
I did another single named We're Extra, and instead of just putting out project after project, I wanted to put out quality material so that people can, you know, realize or see who I am, and just to continue to build up my fan base and to continue building up a following as I grow, and not just put out a bunch of material and not have anybody really gravitate to what I'm doing. So I decided to do singles. And like I said, I created a song called We Extra, and it's a trap type of sound. It's a, actually a trap sound, which is much different. Much different from what I'm accustomed to actually doing, just to kind of show my wide range of flexibility and you know, just range of writing songs.
So that's one thing that I definitely noticed in listening to a lot of the songs that you have out there. You can't really pinpoint your sound. Like, you can do something that gives you like a Caribbean feel. You could do something that gives you like a pop feel. You could do something that gives you R&B. Would you say that you are of a specific type of genre, or would you just say you just a man of the music?
I'm a man of the sound, but if I had to categorize, I'd say more alongside the pop sound, because my influence were Luther Vandross, Whitney Houston, Michael Jackson, even a bit of Madonna. I mean, those sounds and those sounds are like being free and being, you know, genuine. True love in our hearts or in our minds, and expressing those type of things is what I wanted to write and the kind of environment I want to create for myself.
So I wanted to get into like your creative process, because I know that when it comes to sometimes a creative process could be different for everyone. So what is your creative process like? Like, what gets you motivated?
Wow, good question. What gets me going is life, right? Because we're inspired by every day. We're inspired by the way we feel about what we see and the way our environment is shaping our lives right now. What do we want to feel? We want to feel a sense of freedom, right? So what inspires me is melody. What inspires me, and my process is normally, I always have a scratch pad, a notebook, and I always keep a pencil, because I always have to rewrite and rewrite lyrics. But as I go along, I'm the lyrics come to me, and the songs write themselves. So a lot of times, I mean, I normally never have to fish and wonder what it is I'm going to write next. It just flows to me. And, you know, I was just talking to someone just the other day, and they were talking about how they may experience writer's block. And I had to tell them, I was like, I never experienced writer's block. It's just way too many experiences. There's just way too many inspirations, people, feelings, thoughts that we have for me to sit there and have no, and have a loss for words, right? So I jot my thoughts down. I come back, I revisit the melody. And if it makes sense, according to where the beat is going and how I feel about things and feel about where I am in that present moment, I write it.
Mm-hmm. That's dope.
All right, now. Yes, that's super dope. So, and being an artist and being able to have your music, your lyrics touch all different types of people, what is it that you want people to walk away with from hearing your music? What is it that you want the audience to get from you?
Yes, I want them to gather that I'm just a really dope songwriter. I feel like anybody, if you're given the right moment and you're in the studio, and these engineers today, producers these days, can have anyone feeling or doing a good job vocally. But I want people to walk away from what I've done and say that this was the song structure, and I just feel great and wonderful after hearing some of his music. And then I hope that this guy does wonders and really is around for quite a long time.
That's actually, that's pretty dope too. So you said that creatively you had a lot of influences from Whitney Houston to Madonna. Those are a lot of people in the past. Who are some of your current artists that you that influences? Because you said something about trap as well, so I want to get into that. And if there was any artist that you can open up for, who would it be?
Wow, if I could open up for someone, I'd say Rick Ross. I appreciate the grind from day one all the way to what we know him as now. You know, there's a lot of, you know, misnomer and stigma attached to his name and everything. However, if you look at the core of him beginning from writing for other artists and being behind the scenes for nearly two decades to the time that he was actually put on to actually being in the game another 15 years or so, is someone that I look up to in that essence.
Definitely.
And just putting out quality music, putting out good melodies and strong punchline, lyrics, all that, you know, jumbled up into one, is what I admire about him. And so I like Drake also. I'm sorry?
I said, yeah, you would open up for him, Drake. But you were also, I want you to finish what you were saying. I'm sorry, I was just agreeing, going along with what you were talking about already.
Yeah, I would open up for Drake. I would open up Tory Lanez. I mean, these guys have already gotten deals. These guys have been around and become household names already. And I just want to align myself with some of the great names, because lyrics and melody in music is what I'm all about, and I stand by that. I think that stands the test of time. I believe that as we continue to move and transcend through our lives, we will remember those lyrics, and we will remember those melodies the most. I mean, trap is fine. And it's good for the moment. And in fact, what we do, we turn it up in the car on our way somewhere. But really, we remember those old hits. Those old hits stick around in our mind. If you are connoisseur of music, those old songs stick out in your mind. And I don't believe we're going to remember too many of the trap songs when we're a little older.
Yeah, most definitely. I get what you're saying. So one thing that I think about certain artists is the crossover potential. And then some people might look at crossover as selling out, but then some artists have taken what you call crossover and have done amazing things with it. Beyonce has dipped into country. Snoop has dipped into gospel and reggae and everything else. Is there a certain genre of music that you would consider crossing over into?
My background, actually, I'm American, but my family, I'm the first generation Jamaican and Guyanese. And I would definitely like to get more in the dance hall, dabble, but not be my main, but just to do, I just want to do hit music, honestly. I just want to do hit music, hit records, feel good stuff. That transcends the time. So that definitely is something that I want to get into, is more dancehall, reggae, and soca, that type of stuff. And country, not so much. but all genres of music are fine by me.
Okay, all right. So now that we talked about it, you got into your Caribbean background, because yes, I have a Caribbean background as well. So who were some of your influences, as far as like in culture wise, that influenced you into music, if any at all? Because it doesn't necessarily mean, just because Bob is one of the greatest don't mean that you got to necessarily name him.
Yeah.
But who were some of the artists? You
don't have to name him, but that's who it is. Because the reason why, the reason why I say Bob is because Bob gave you all the elements. There was even elements of rapping in some of what he did.
I mean, rap came from reggae.
Early on.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I turn it on and I enjoy. What I mean by that is I may not even know who the artist is, but I enjoy and I vibe out, a lot. Yeah, it's music and it's melody and everything. And like I said, but if one name stuck out to me, it was Bobby, only because he covered all the bases. He always covered all the bases.
So with you being new to the game as a solo artist, but then having experience as a producer, manager, writer, what would you tell the next up and coming? What's the best advice you would give to somebody trying to follow in your footsteps?
I always tell them, take care of the business side of things. I know a lot of people want to put their careers and put their music in the hands of another person to take care of business for them. But no, you must be abreast of the business side of things. Enlist yourself with ASCAP, BMI. Make sure that you understand the lingo. Make sure you understand the percentages. Just make sure that you are abreast of all the business.
Seems like we have a bit of a connection.
The signal's dipping out just a little bit.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I said the other thing would be. I'm sorry.
Your signal was going out.
Oh, okay.
Okay, say something now.
Okay, where are
you? Okay.
Yeah, I'm
back. We're good.
Okay. The other thing I would tell them is stay true to who you are. stay true to who you are, and you ride that wave. You stay right there and ride that wave all the way to the end.
That's good.
Okay. So you guys, earlier before the interview started, I kind of mentioned just a little bit how I just pulled up on him the other day. Okay, he was out doing a video, doing a photo shoot. I said, you know, this brother looked like he's somebody. So how did your shoot go? First off, you looked amazing. Okay, you looked amazing. He definitely, when I saw him, I said, are you an artist? But I already knew just because you had the whole look. But how did your photo shoot go?
Yeah, so I was actually shooting the fourth scene of a new music video for Lifestyle. And so it went spectacularly. The only thing is that I was trying to use the drone at that present time. And so we had to improvise. And that's when I discovered the waterfront and decided to go over there where you were located. And I mean, I'm very pleased to meet you, by the way. It was very nice, you know, that you approached me. I mean, I know a lot of people see people creating or maybe shooting a video and maybe a little apprehensive to step forward and say, hey, hello, or whatever, but you weren't. And I do appreciate that. And I think I did tell you that. But yeah, I mean, everything went perfect. And I'm working with a guy named Matt Funk on that video. And he's 20 years old. So I look forward to the project and how it comes out. You weren't aware of it, but I had the 2021 Corvette Stingray, and I had a good time shooting with that. So I'm pretty sure that this video is going to come out well.
Yeah, I'm excited to see it too.
Yeah. I'm excited too. Look, now that I know that it was actual video shoot, I'm excited to see the end product. I looked at a little bit of the teaser for the collaboration that you did. Oh my gosh, I can't think of the man's name. Lopez. What's his name? Sorry.
B. Lopez.
Collaborator. Got like
B. Lopez.
Yeah, so I looked at, I guess, the teaser or the trailer for that. That looks super interesting. So is that what you are trying to bring across in your videos, is more of a story or short film type vibe?
Absolutely. That is number one paramount. And I got a lot of that from the likes of Michael Jackson, Prince. They always had like a storyline behind the music, so to speak, that illustrated the moment they were in while creating that music, right? So the teaser I believe you're referring to took place last year. We did a compilation album called Positive Vibes, and that album really did well. And I think that is honestly what actually propelled me to want to continue creating more and more song and more and more music. So yeah.
Well, everything happens on purpose, and I'm a firm believer in fluidity. You moving your location, you us missing out on one thing, but then something else presenting itself. So this definitely was intentional and on purpose. So shout out to the universe, because you're all about fluidity when it comes to creativity. So, you know, shout out to the universe.
Absolutely. Shout out to the universe. I also want to say
it was a pleasure having you on.
I also want to say a shout out to the late Chucky Thompson. He was also the pioneer for DC area music and the young people. And he passed away this past Sunday and everything. And I just want to say
Comment went out. It went out, sir. So he pretty much was just saying that he rest in peace to Chucky Thompson, which we also covered in the beginning segment. He piggybacked exactly what I said by saying Chucky was for the younger artists and for the community. He had a lot of different projects that he worked on, Grammy nominated, just the overall outstanding person. And again, I said, if you are an up and coming artist and you do not know Chucky, then you don't know anyone. So rest in peace to you, Chucky. Your friends are definitely, definitely missing you in the physical, but your energy will circulate the world forever. We can almost guarantee that your presence is still very much felt to this day. So may you continue to rest in peace. Yeah. What a good guy.
Most definitely. Like that era. Yo, for any of us who are like, 35 to 40, whatever, yep. Early 40s, like that's what we came up on. Like that sound, definitely a sound that shaped my love of music as a teenager. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Our style, everything. Yeah, and saying, I think sometimes we sometimes forget how influential these people are until something happens. I forgot how influential Biz Markie was until something happened. You know what I mean? Like, and I hate that it's like that though, you guys. I hate that it's like that. And I hope that we kind of take stock of how good this music is to us and how it pushes us, how it moves us, how it motivates us, how it gets us through our day, whatever the case may be, so that some of these people can get their flowers while they're here. Because I'm sure in the past 15, 20 years, Chucky Thompson probably wanted to hear all these accolades and everything else that so many people have to say. But yo, like,
and he did, because he was a loving person.
Yeah.
He was an openly, from what I gather, he was an openly loving person. So he told everybody he came across, I love you, man. Like, I want to see you do good. I want to see you be better. So, like, yeah, that's where it's at. This was an awesome show tonight. Again, it was a pleasure having you on. Where can the people find you? Give us some insight. Where can they locate you, you and your music? How can we get in tune?
I'm all over Spotify. I'm all over YouTube. I have tons of videos. As you can see right there on the screen, Blacksmith, BlackQSmith, the banger. But my handle on Instagram is Blacksmith Sound. And on Facebook, it's just Blacksmith. If you spell it correctly, it'll take you right to everything. But you can find me on Spotify and on YouTube.
All right, now.
Okay, well, we definitely look forward to more new music. You guys get into the song lifestyle. You can hit his page. You can hear a little bit of it. Make sure you download it. Support this man. Get on every streaming platform. Buy his songs, y'all. Don't just listen to him for free. But make sure that you also follow our guest, you guys, because definitely going to be a force in music. I can't wait to see the new video. I can't wait to see just your growth and your progress as an artist. You have an amazing voice. We dig in your sound. Anytime you have some new music and you want to showcase it, come on and bring it here to illustrate. Yes, come on and bring it here to illustrate.
I truly appreciate it, ladies. And I continue to watch your show and continue to monitor your growth as well. All the best.
Thank you. We appreciate that. All right, well, just in case everyone missed us, or if you missed us, you can always catch us on 7.od.net, and that is online. That's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So if you don't have Roku TV, you can always go online. Don't forget that you can also watch our episodes on our YouTube channel. Please like and subscribe on Illustrate Radio, and I look forward to having everyone again back next week. But before we get into all of that, let me make sure y'all follow me at Magical AF Podcast. I have a new episode out, and it's super dope. It's basically talking about unfucking yourself. Yes, unfuck yourselves. It's not what you think it is, but it kind of is. And I got a couple of juicy things in there too, like the position of the week. So make sure y'all get into that butter churner. But T. Gray, where can they find you?
You guys already know you can find me at BT Gray or the love below underscore sex talk with T. Gray. You already know I got something crazy coming up. This month I decided to shine some light on some of the internet comedians. I know that there's a lot happening in comedy, and there's a lot between stand-up and internet comedians, but these internet comedians have been keeping us vigilant, keeping us entertained the whole pandemic, and they need some love. So coming up, I have this young guy, Mo Funny's got like millions of people watching him. Clearly he thinks it's funny, but let's see if he can talk about sex. So it's going to be interesting. Y'all check me out next week.
I can't wait. I'm excited because you be having some really good guests. Like the last, hold up, no, it wasn't the female. What was the guy who was saying something?
Malik
about,
S.
He don't know how to
right.
tell her how
Malik
to.
Malik S. If you all ever watched The Neighborhood with Cedric the Entertainer, he's actually an actor on there as well, but he's also a comedian. It was an interesting interview. Right, because you know me, I'm all about energy, and he was not giving me what I needed.
But he was
not anyway.
But it was still good.
Check it out.
Still good nonetheless. I love watching you. I think what you're doing is super dope and fire. I also want to let DJ Saleto know that I've been watching your shoe game, and I'm excited to know that you have some 11s, and I definitely will be copping a pair before the weekend is out. So y'all make sure y'all check out House of Stiletto, and I wear size 11 and I like bright colors. So make sure you got something for the big feet girls. Okay. But go ahead and take us away, DJ Stiletto. Make sure you got me out here grooving. But before you do that, make sure you get something where to find
Hold
you, boo boo.
And
I'll
see y'all
next week.
Y'all come back. 9 to 10 p.m. Make sure you check us out at 7 on demand. Make sure you listen to us at iHeartRadio, you guys. Make sure you don't miss a beat. Get on your Roku. Download 7 on demand. Catch us Wednesdays at 8 o'clock.
All right. So I'm going to head out. I'm going to do this one for Chucky. I was actually a big fan of him and his work. So I'm going to just play a few of his hit songs, and we're going to go out like that. I catch us each and every Wednesday from 9 to 10. You already know it's Illustrate.
Oh, go Chucky.
Yes. We'll see y'all next Wednesday on each and every platform. This is Illustrate Radio from 9 to 10. Peace and blessings.